So now let's talk about E1CB, where E represents elimination, 1 is unimolecular. From conjugate base, CB here indicates conjugate base. So here it is an elimination reaction. So whenever we have an elimination reaction, we use high temperature over there. So now if we know that it is an acid, and this is an acid, okay. So this is an acid, and it has a very weak leaving group over here, okay. Fluoride ion, we have already seen. Fluorine is a very blue weak leaving group. We have seen previously while comparing the Hoffman and Sentzeff reaction that there are some weak leaving group. So they made first the conjugate base, okay. First they made, it is again obviously an base, it is a base. So this base make a acid base reaction first. So when there is acid base reaction, so this conjugate base is formed. We know acid base reaction is very fast, so it do not let the fluorine move at the same time. So it's stay when there is a conjugate base. Now when fluorine start to moving over from there, and this negative charge over trying to occupy to get the double bond, so here we will be getting, here it is an alkene. So alkene we will be getting. So it is a conjugate base, and it is forming a stable carb anion, and it has a poor leaving group. And first of all, we should also be seeing that the carb anion we should be getting very stable. So more it is getting stable, more it will be moving towards E1CB reaction. So we know here it is very more stable because it has a lot of minus I groups over there. So a lot of minus I groups over there which are trying to keep it here. They are trying to stay the negative charge over here. So it is a redetermining mining step when the sigma bond is trying to break with a force. Okay, so there is a formation of alkene. If we see the characteristic of the reaction, so if we see this reaction, so we know rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the carb anion. Here the only the rate is dependent on the carb anion. If we check the rate determining step, the rate is directly proportional to the concentration of carb anion only. Now we know if we talk about this equilibrium. In this equilibrium, the K is, here it is an equilibrium, the K is rate constant. Here it is equilibrium constant. Here at equilibrium, this acid base reaction, it is equilibrium constant. Now it is an equilibrium constant. Now rate is directly proportional to concentration of carbon ion. And we put the equilibrium constant, the concentration of reactant divided by concentration of product, multiplication of concentration of product. This is the equilibrium we get from the ionic equilibrium equation. We know K, the rate constant or the equilibrium constant of this reaction, it is written by this. Now we know that if we put the value of carbon ion from here by cross multiplying these. Now when we cross multiply these over K into ethoxide ion concentration and concentration of halide concentration. So here carbon ion is equals to K multiplied by this and this. So if we put the value of carbon ion over here, so we get this value. So rate is equals to multiplication of concentration of ethoxide and concentration of halide. Now if we talk about order and molecularity, here we say that order of the reaction is 2 and molecularity also we are getting 2. Now if you see the examples of this reaction, now like if you see this example, now is this example, we know the negative charge here is very stable and it is a purely base. It is a base over here and it is a base over here. So base here and we are getting a hydrogen. We need to find first of all hydrogen which should be very reactive. And we are also supplying the heat in the reaction. So ETO minus the ethoxide ion will attack over this. And then there will be a generation of negative charge. When there will be a generation of negative charge, we are keep on providing heat to the reaction. The reaction will proceed and it will form an alkene. So this alkene we are getting. Now we know molecularity is 1 over the reaction. Here the molecularity is 1. So we know that molecularity is 1 because RDS has only 1 molecule, but order is 2. So in that case, order and molecularity are different. So now if you see this reaction more, here we know this is a hydrogen. This hydrogen is a very acidic hydrogen, is a base. So it's gonna react over here, it's gonna make negative charge first, then it's gonna move the That's a poor living group. Here we need a poor living group, and near the poor living group it should be a strong acid part, by removing of which the negative charge is getting stimuli. So this reaction proceeds through, we call it as a E1CB reaction. It is not purely E1 reaction, but even it is E1 following through conjugate base. So first we form the conjugate base, then it is somehow first order elimination reaction.